Hello students, welcome to another interesting topic in English grammar. It's tenses. In today's session, we are going to cover simple present tense, simple past tense, and simple future tense. Coming to the first topic of tenses, we have simple present tense. Let's come to the rules so that it is very clear how to use a simple present tense. First rule is, we add s or es to the root form of verb when we have singular subjects, he, she, or it. Next rule is, we use the root form of verb with plural subjects, I, we, you, or they. Before going to the exercises, let's see some examples of singular and plural subjects. As we have seen the rule that we use s or es to the root form of verbs for singular subjects. Some of the examples of singular subjects are teacher, student, mother, leg, fox, banana, clock, bed, etc. Now you all know that we use root form of verbs for plural subjects. Some of the examples of plural subjects are parents, students, benches, leaders, animals, players, shop. Now that we know the rules for using s or es in present tense and we know the singular and plural subjects, let's do one exercise. Let's fill in the blanks with right form of the verbs in simple present tense. The first sentence is, she dashed for a walk after dinner. What is the right form of go? It will be goes. She goes for a walk after dinner. Next sentence, birds dash eggs in their nests. What is the right form of the verb lay? Here it will be birds lay eggs in their nests because it's a plural subject, birds. Next sentence, I dash my hands with a soap. What is the correct form of wash? It will be I wash my hands with a soap because we use the root form of verb with I. Next sentence is, spiders dash webs. What is the right form of verb spin? It will be spiders spin webs because spiders is plural subject. Next sentence, the sun dash us light and heat. The right form of give will be gives. The sun gives us light and heat because sun is singular subject. Next sentence, students dash quiet when the teacher explains the chapter. What is the right form of the verb keep? It will be keep itself. Students keep quiet when the teacher explains the chapter because students is plural subject. Coming to the second topic, it's simple past tense. Let's go through the rules. We use ed to the root form of verb to make a sentence in past tense. The next rule is very important, children. The past tense of all the verbs may not end with ed. Now that we have seen the rules of simple past tense, let's fill in the blanks with the right form of verbs in simple past tense. The first sentence is, the lion dash on the deer to kill it. What is the right form of jump in simple past tense? It will be jumped. Next sentence is, they dash gifts for their friends. Kids, what is the right form of purchase in simple past tense? It will be purchased. The next sentence is, the boy dashed the door. The right form of close will be closed. The next sentence is, Jack dashed from the tree. What is the right form of the verb fall? Here it will be fell. The next sentence is, both of them dashed the hill. The right form of the verb climb will be climbed. The next sentence is, she dashed the dog's life. The right form of save will be saved. The last sentence is, mother dash potato wedges for the snacks. The right form of the verb fry is fried. Coming to the third form of tense, the simple future tense. Let's see the rules. We use will or shall to make a sentence in simple future tense. The next rule is, shall is used with I and we, but we can use will with all the subjects. Now that we have seen the rules, let's do one exercise based on simple future tense. The first sentence is, the train dash at 4 p.m. sharp. The right form of leave is will leave. The second sentence is, migratory birds dash here in November. The right form of come in future tense is will come. I dash some flowering plants. The right form of buy in future tense is shall buy. Children, we can also write will buy. That is also correct. The next sentence is, they dash into their new home soon. The right form of move is will move. Mr. Shah dash our new chairman. The right form of be is will be. It dash heavily today. The right form of rain in future tense is will rain. We dash for the movie tomorrow. The right form of go in future tense is will go. Children, I hope you have understood all the rules for simple present tense, simple past tense and simple future tense. Now, are you all ready to do an exercise on mixed tenses? Let's see the question. It is, identify the verbs and tell the tense of these sentences. The first one is, the clever fox thought of a plan. Can you identify the verb in it? Correct, it is thought. And the tense is simple past tense. Next sentence, I go to bed early at night. Any guesses for verb? It's go. And it is simple present tense. Next sentence, my sister wraps all the gifts. The verb is wraps. And the tense is simple present tense. The last sentence, they will certainly help you. The verb is help. And the sentence is in simple future tense.
Now, for recap of all the form of tenses, let's see a video.